Okay, hello cloud gurus. Welcome back to another episode of AWS This Week. This week, I am joined by a very special mystery guest. The manufacturing sector gets some new tools and inspiration. The well-architected framework continues its continuous improvement march. AWS ECS gets a co-pilot, and we reveal the guru of the week right here on AWS This Week with me, Scott Pletcher. Decades before IoT was a cool buzzword, the manufacturing crowd has been collecting masses of data about every aspect of their factory floor equipment, helping them ensure consistent quality, efficiency, and uptime. Now, while those data collection methods have been around for a long time, they were and often are proprietary and not easy to integrate with other platforms. To help customers bridge this proprietary gap, AWS introduced IoT SiteWise, which became generally available last week. SiteWise consists of an on-prem gateway and AWS console parts that you can use to get your local industrial data into the AWS cloud. Now, once it's there, the sky's the limit. For example, you can create live dashboards using QuickSight, a digital twin with RoboMaker, or plan predictive maintenance using SageMaker. Now, another example of this is Virtual Ondon, which is an AWS solution recently released that allows customers to create scalable and fully managed notification systems for their industrial equipment and processes. I am a big fan of the AWS well-architected framework, and certainly what I recommend to those organizations ready to stick their big toe into the cloud for the first time. As the framework is used with customers and partners, small improvements are noted based on real-world experiences and evolving business needs. Now, every so often, AWS bundles these improvements up in a new release of the framework, and one of those releases dropped on July 9th. Now, don't go throwing all those carefully crafted enterprise architecture documents into the burn pile just yet. Some parts have been added, some parts have been consolidated. For example, there's a new cloud financial management section under the cost optimization pillar. And I'm particularly happy to see some new additions under the operational excellence pillar that focus more on organization and culture, something too often overlooked in cloud adoptions. Well, guess what, intrepid gurus? As promised at the top of the program, I do have a little surprise guest up my sleeve. Welcome back to the show, Faye Ellis. Faye, so nice to see you again. How are you doing?
Hi everyone, I'm doing great, thanks Scott, and it's awesome to be back in the saddle.
Excellent. Why don't you share with us something that you found new and noteworthy this week?
So this week, AWS announced a new command line interface for Elastic Container Service, or ECS, and it's called Copilot. Now, if you haven't used ECS before, it's a managed service which allows you to run Docker containers in AWS. And Copilot is a command line tool which can be used to develop, release, and operate containerized applications. So the great thing with Copilot is that with just a single command, you can create all of the infrastructure required for a production-ready environment, including built-in patterns for security and scalability. And it also integrates with code pipeline for continuous integration and continuous deployment. Thank you, Scott. Have a wonderful week and take care, everyone.
Thank you so much, Faye. I know I and all the other gurus out there are eager for you to get back into the regular rotation. Well, my friends, the time is upon us once again. It is Guru of the Week time. Who is going to grab that brass ring this week? Congratulations to Martin Stephanie, a senior architecture consultant from Prague, Czechia. This question stumped many people, but Martin was unfaltering in his confidence. A spectacular swag pack is on its way to you now, and provided reInvent happens this year, you've also been entered into a draw for said event. Feel free to take a swing at this week's question linked down below. And that, my friends, is all the AWS news that's fit to print this week. Big thanks to Faye for dropping in. Stay safe, take care of one another, and keep being awesome, cloud gurus.